still in the education sector, members of the Education Service Commission have revealed to Parliament's Committee on Education on how government is losing over 7 billion shillings annually paying ghost teachers who use forged documents. Here is more.
Officials from the Education Service Commission were appearing before the Committee on Education over the budget for the upcoming fiscal year 2021-2022. The chairperson of the commission, Reverend Professor Sam Luboga, told the members of the committee that according to the investigations internally, it has been discovered that there are teachers on the government payroll that have never been employed by them.
During the validation exercise, we have called people with appointment letters, quoting minutes that do not exist, who are drawing salaries from the payroll. Therefore, for you to ask, is it there? It is there. It is that since we have caught it, help us to widen the scope and help to stamp it up.
Reverend Professor Luboga adds that they are to review these kind of payrolls in several parts of the country and the region, with most cases being in Teso.
And that is a sample. And you cannot sample, find a problem, and then be satisfied that the sample is the entire problem. So we need to do as much as is possible, a countrywide exercise.
The professor agrees that this matter is among those that are pressing issues that gives them sleepless nights. He wonders how teachers are using unauthorized documents to earn positions on the payroll.
Member of staff's appointment letter, and we check the minute that appointed them, because it is quoted in the appointment letter. And many are times when we cross-check this minute, we find actually it doesn't exist in our database.
When asked on what could be the root cause of the problem, the professor denied having any knowledge about this, but insisted they were investigating the matter. In 2018, it was reported that government was paying some primary school teachers, including ghost teachers, at least shillings 7 million per month. Some of the ghosts had been paid salary advances then up to April 2018. Story compiled by Rachel Nakasi and Obed Lutale for the news in Parliament.